It feels like it was just a few weeks ago that I was at another Elon Musk special event. But here I went again, this time to Florida for a SpaceX Falcon Heavy launch in Cape Canaveral, Florida. It was a hurry up and wait experience with multiple delays to see the Falcon Heavy launch a 6,000 kilogram or 13,000 pound Lockheed Martin-built Arab 6A satellite into orbit. It's only the Falcon Heavy's second flight and first commercial flight, but it's an important milestone and one that got me thinking about why companies like SpaceX are critical to the future of spaceflight and exploration. And also, getting to see the most powerful rocket currently in operation take off. There was that too. We all know the origins of the space race and how the Cold War between the US and the Soviet Union spurred rapid exploration and innovation into spaceflight. After things cooled off and the Apollo program was shelved, we entered into an era of more mundane space exploration. This is when the science of space exploration really took the lead, but it's also a time where public interest began to wane. In the US, the NASA budget is always under incredible scrutiny and considered wasteful by some, even though NASA's entire budget is less than 0.5% of the entire federal budget. Or as Neil deGrasse Tyson put it, if you hold up a literal dollar and then take scissors and cut 0.5% of its width, you don't even get into the ink from the side of the dollar. That's why companies like SpaceX and Blue Origin are so important. They're helping to commoditize spaceflight by making it cheaper and more efficient. In order to do that, we have to stop being wasteful and reuse our rockets. Imagine if we threw away an entire airplane, or most of it, after each flight. But even a system that's reusable isn't guaranteed to be the cheapest method. The space shuttle was reusable, but it was also a very expensive operation. The absolutely fantastic YouTube channel, The Everyday Astronaut, did a great breakdown comparing the Falcon Heavy to the space shuttle. I'll include a link in the description and recommend watching it. But at a high level, here's how it breaks down. For the space shuttle, NASA charged $450 million for a liftoff to carry up to 27,500 kilograms of payload. That's a $16,363 per kilogram charge. In comparison, for the Falcon Heavy, SpaceX charges $90 million to carry up to 30,000 kilograms in payload for about a $3,000 per kilogram cost. So why the huge gap in cost? Well, first is time. There's been a lot of advancements in the past 40 plus years since the space shuttle was first developed and built. Second is that we were still figuring out the basics of spaceflight. The space shuttle was a very complex vehicle that required a lot of maintenance, some of which cost a lot more than was originally expected. For instance, the thermal protection tiles turned out to be incredibly labor-intensive and costly to maintain and manufacture. In comparison, you have a company like SpaceX that doesn't have any baggage to deal with, but the benefit of what came before. Tackling affordable spaceflight with a clean slate in modern technologies and techniques gives SpaceX the edge. SpaceX is also run like a more modern company, one that's not afraid to stop in its tracks to make changes to a design and not fall victim to the sunk cost fallacy. The Falcon Heavy, which is based off the Falcon 9, was announced in 2011, just a year or two after the Falcon 9 had just gotten off the ground. The original intent was to have a heavier load capacity available within a couple of years with the Falcon Heavy. However, we didn't see the first launch of the Falcon Heavy until Elon shot his Tesla into space in 2018. So why the delay? Well, the Falcon 9 had some maturing to do, and SpaceX team saw ways to significantly improve the platform. Some of those improvements gave the Falcon 9 much heavier lift capability on its own, which caused delays and rethinking for the Falcon Heavy. It's that kind of nimbleness that allowed SpaceX to not get bogged down in the, we've already spent this much money, we might as well go the rest of the way to just use what we've got type of thinking. The improvements to the Falcon 9 ended up with bigger improvements to the Falcon Heavy, which in the end is helping the capacity that we're able to launch into space now and the final cost per launch. And I may be opening a Pandora's box here by bringing this up, but there's also the giant question of why spend money exploring and sending things into space in the first place? We have enough problems down here. For me, there's a few good reasons. First is innovation. We have so many things that we take for granted in our daily lives that came through the innovations funded by NASA. Some recent examples are GPS signal correction software created by GPL, which enhances precision for agriculture, airplane navigation, and smartphone locations. Or the systems used to bring back samples from Mars being used now in life-saving sutures during heart surgery. or a lightweight, high-pressure tank NASA invented to hold rocket fuel being used to store oxygen to keep pilots, firefighters, and intensive care patients breathing. There's a massive list of items I could run through. Second is learning. By exploring space, we learn more about how our planet was formed and how it's currently changing. Looking at our sister planets in the solar system and around the galaxy, we learn not only how we got here, but where things might be heading. Third is inspiration. And this is the big one for me and ties back strongly to the first two points. John F. Kennedy's rallying cry.
We choose to go to the moon in this decade and do the other things, not because they are easy, but because they are hard. Because that goal will serve to organize and measure the best of our energies and skills. Because that challenge is one that we're willing to accept, one we are unwilling to postpone, and one we intend to win.
We get inspired by seeing what humankind is able to achieve when we put our minds and efforts to it. Setting what seems like an insurmountable goal helps us to push ourselves to do things we never thought possible. And achieving those impossible goals helps to inspire future scientists and researchers, which in turn helps to enable the innovation that powers our economy and the world. If you couldn't tell, I'm kind of an optimist here. We've been benefiting from the innovations discovered by the research of NASA and other organizations for the past 40 years. SpaceX's ultimate goal is to send people to Mars and colonize it, to make humankind multiplanetary. It's a grand vision, and one that will bring along with it many more innovations and advancements. With companies like SpaceX and Blue Origin handling the launch vehicles, it frees NASA up to focus on the science and the exploration. Ultimately, being able to achieve a lot more for the same amount of money. But there's also this last point. Getting to see the world's most powerful rocket in operation, take off. So the secret Level 3 Tesla event was held at Exploration Tower, which is about 15 kilometers from the launch site. It's the tallest building in the area, so we had an unobstructed view to the launch site. After three delays and 5 days past the original launch date, SpaceX was finally able to launch. One of the things that surprised me was how bright the rocket was in the sky. It doesn't come across in the video, but it was a little painful to look at. Almost like a tiny little sun coming out of the back of the rocket.
It wasn't delayed, yeah.
It was funny to hear how long it took for the sound from takeoff to reach us that far away, but also impressive at how loud it still was at that distance.
Oh my God.
But the absolute coolest part was seeing the boosters land themselves. For that, we had an amazing view because we were less than 5 kilometers away.
Oh my God.
That's good, that's good.
It's
supposed to be that.
That's normal. No way. Look at that.
That is incredible.
It was a little like something out of a sci-fi movie, watching them straighten their descent, fire their boosters at what felt like the last possible moment, and then touch down gently.
Yeah, baby!
Yeah!
Oh, yeah!
Got it?
And then there was the sonic boom from the booster breaking the speed of sound during descent. Again, it didn't hit us until after the boosters had already landed, and it caught a few of us by surprise. This has been something I've been wanting to see in person since I was a little kid and saw the first space shuttle take off on TV. In 2011, I was invited to a NASA special event to see the Grail mission launch, which included talking to the scientists involved with the mission, getting a tour of the vehicle assembly building, seeing the space shuttle getting decommissioned, and spending the better part of a day with Neil deGrasse Tyson. An amazing experience, but it ended with the launch getting scrubbed due to high altitude wind shear. 8 years later, and thanks to Tesla, I got a front row seat to see one of the world's most powerful rockets take off and land. An absolutely crazy experience that I wouldn't trade for anything. And I have to give the Tesla referral team a big thank you for putting together such a great event, dealing with the delays and making sure all of us got to see the launch. And an even bigger thank you to all of you that used my Tesla referral code and made this possible. Thank you. Now, if you like this video, be sure to give it a thumbs up and share with your friends because it really helps the channel. And comment below if you watched the live stream of the launch or if you were there and saw it in person too. How many other space nerds do we have out there? And if you'd like to support the channel, there are some ways that you can do so. Want some cool t-shirts like the one I'm wearing? Check out my SFSF shop for some cool Tesla, SpaceX, science, and Undecided t-shirts. Every purchase helps to support the channel. Get some great Tesla accessories like console wraps, LED lights, and more from Abstract Ocean and save 15% off your first order with my referral code. And a big thank you to all of my Patreon supporters. Your support and encouragement goes a really long way. You can also become an Undecided supporter on Patreon to help grow and shape the channel. If you're interested, please check out my Patreon page for additional details, and I hope to see some of you over there. And if you haven't already, consider subscribing and hitting the notification bell to get alerts when I post new videos. And as always, thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.